Hello, everyone! Hoot hoot, everyone! It's me, Ethan, that there Turbo Owl. And I'm here with some war for the Overworld. Why am I here with some war for the Overworld, starting a campaign in War for the Overworld? Because I can't remember if I've ever played War for the Overworld on stream. Or if I ever did it on the channel. I feel like I've never streamed it, but I feel like I probably at least covered it once on the YouTube channel. It's a game I really like. If you don't know what it is, it's effectively Dungeon Keeper 3. That was, like, explicitly what it was designed to be. A spiritual successor to Dungeon Keeper 3, to the point at which War for the Overworld was, if I recall correctly, one of the, like, in-development titles for Dungeon Keeper 3. That was, like, conceptually what Dungeon Keeper 3 was going to be. Recently, I've been watching the anime Overlord, which gave me a real hankering to play an evil, a generically evil Overlord type with a bunch of random monsters working for him. So we're gonna do this. I've actually weirdly been playing Dungeons recently, like the Dungeons games, which if you don't know, are also kind of attempting to be successors to Dungeon Keeper. Although they've gone a bit of a different route in that they've kind of combined it with like a simple Warcraft-esque strategy layer where you do actually go out onto the overworld. In this one it is still, despite the name, we're still fighting everything down here. Okay. We're gonna reset the campaign progress, because I actually, like, had just started a new campaign on my own time. But yeah. We're gonna play War for the Overworld. I guess we'll start with the intro cutscene, because it's been a minute. I don't even remember what's in the intro cutscene, so yeah, fuck it. Let's play the intro cutscene.
Now go!
Welcome back, Underlord. I must say, I wasn't expecting you quite so soon. The transference may have left you feeling a bit foggy in the head. Focus now. I'll try to ease you back into it. Fortunately, this does seem to get easier each time. This is your home realm, the source of your power, and the anchor that binds you to reality. Many years ago, it was destroyed, and you were cast out into formless nothing. Fortunately, you've returned from your exile to once again challenge those who would stand between us and the mortal realm of Kairos. Your resurrection heralds the next phase of our assault upon its wretched empire. Now led by the newly crowned Emperor Lucius. But he is least and final of our worries. It's his generals and the protection of their goddess Kira that will truly test our mettle. Ready yourself, Underlord. Let's begin our war for the Overworld.
Cool. Also, I love that voice actor. I absolutely adore him. I believe he's the guy who voiced the narrator in the original Dungeon Keeper games as well. I think that was, like, actually a bit of a get for the originals was for this game, was that they got that guy back. I've always wanted to see what Dungeon Keeper-type games were like. Well, this is basically literally Dungeon Keeper, so this is, like, I don't think I've ever played... War for the Overworld is one of those games that's in that, like, handful of games that are just another game just made by a different developer. You know, like how Stardew Valley is essentially just Harvest Moon. Like, it's explicitly, like, that's what it's meant to be. How City Skylines is basically just SimCity, but, like, made by... Do you know what I mean? War for the Overworld is that, but with Dungeon Keeper. Okay, so let's just go with the first level, Oberon's Realm.
I've been looking for someone to spearhead my campaign. But before we get stuck in, let's refresh that old mind of yours.
One of the weird things, actually, that only just occurred to me is that the guy who voices the narrator in this game, who I think it's revealed later on in the game's, like, plot that he's not just the narrator. I can't remember his name, but he's, like, he's essentially the god of evil as well. Like, and we are effectively demons that work for him. Like he is effectively this setting's version of Satan. He also voices, Thorgrim Grudgebearer in Total War Warhammer, which is fairly amusing because, you know, the world is called Kairos, and you know what else is Kairos? Kairos Fateweaver, the greater demon of Tzeentch, that is the leader of the Tzeentch faction in Total War Warhammer 3. Yeah. Also, do expect it to hitch a bit when levels load in. I don't know why. War for the Overworld's always done that. Like, yeah, I don't know why.
You've returned as a husk of your former self, but I've taught far denser underlords than you. Let's start with the basics. This is your dungeon core. The tether that allows you to manifest your malignant will. If destroyed, your consciousness will once again be scattered to the void.
I feel like the game's gonna get mad at me for the fact that I'm like immediately trying to build things that it's not told me to build. I hope this game's well made enough that this isn't gonna break anything.
Put them to work by clicking and dragging your cursor upon the flashing tiles to tag them for excavation. Your workers will now rush forth to dig out and claim the tagged area. Once they have laid down the
marking the ground. Yeah, fuck it. Because the game's gonna throw a fit. Wow, it literally is just Dungeon Keeper. Yeah, again, this guy is the narrator for Dungeon Keeper. Like, it's literally Dungeon Keeper. Like, it is as literally Dungeon Keeper as it could possibly be. Like, it does. Like, it's not even that it doesn't try to hide it. Like, marketed itself on the fact that it's just Dungeon Keeper 3.
First, you'll need to build the rooms necessary to entice them in. Start by building a barracks.
Like, dungeons is more of a, like, unique experience, when compared to the Dungeon Keeper games.
Or disfigurement. Select it and build it by clicking and dragging your hand across the claim.
I see if I can buy Overlord on my Series S and level again.
In order to function.
I'm not it.
So the lair and vault are effective at any size.
Ah shit, we don't have enough gold for it. Hang on. Just quietly mine some more gold here real fast. You know, it is literally Dungeon Keeper. I've been meaning to play more strategy games on the channel. I don't know why I don't, honestly. Because there's, like, a bunch of strategy slash base building games that I want to play. Especially given the fact that, like, it seems to me that, especially since I've started streaming, it's a lot more acceptable for there to just be periods in which I'm not talking as much. Which will just happen in games like this. You know, it's the only reason I've not streamed Evil Genius 2. Is because I've been concerned about how much dead air there would be of me streaming that. Attracted by the barrier, I'd say it'd be like one of the only three people who actually liked Evil Genius 2.
And they'll happily hack at your foes until someone is dead. Outside of combat, gnarlings will train themselves within your barracks. You can pick them up with a click if you find them slouching off.
The name Gnarling feels like they thought Goblin was... The name Gnarling feels like they thought Goblin was copyrighted.
Put yourself directly into their head by casting possession upon them.
You know what I mean? I don't know why they're called Gnarlings and not just Goblins. I mean, look at it. It's a Goblin. Come on now. It's a Goblin that talks like Gollum. It's just a fucking Goblin. Like, there's no reason to pretend it's something else. Oh, wait.
You can increase the efficiency of props within your rooms by fortifying the walls.
And yet we do, of course, have the classic...
Workers will fortify walls automatically.
The classic possession spell.
All their other tasks. Now that you have
which screens, lets you see the ceiling.
You will need to cater for their basic needs. First, build
this
a
big fucking hole.
So the pitiful little meat sacks can get some rest.
Remember, this used to be one of the things that I used to, like... obsessively loved doing when I used to play Dungeon Keeper 2 when I was younger was just casting the possession spell on things and just like looking around my dungeon like through the possession, through the eyes of the possession spell. Just like seeing, just like experiencing it as a base. I feel like one of them just said stupid something midget, which I think might have been literally them. A play on the stupid fat hobbitses. Also, one of them just said fatty. Like, their dialogue is definitely a golem thing, right? They're definitely talking about, like, they're definitely, like, supposed to be that. I will say one thing. I know we're not playing dungeons, but I've been playing a lot of specifically dungeons, 2 and 3. Weirdly, Dungeons 1 is like...
Well done. But see how your gold reserves have been depleted. Command your workers to mine some of the nearby gold by tagging the gleaming
tiles. Okay, fuck it, you know what,
but collect and return gold to your dungeon coffers, allowing you to spend it on whatever your dark heart desires.
Fuck it, yeah, just grab that, whatever.
16,000 gold pieces. But if that number sounds pitifully small, or if wealth inspires the evil in you, simply build a vault to store more. Now that you've got a bit of coin in your pocket, you can build a slaughter pen. This room produces scores of micro piglets, a delicacy that will sustain the weak flesh of your minions. By filling their bellies with succulent pig flesh.
If you can't make your evil dungeon look cool, what's the point? Yeah, exactly. But, like, one thing that separates the dungeon game... I know I'm not playing it. I've been playing so much dungeons recently. It's, like, very much on my brain. The dungeons games are kind of weird compared to... They're given what they're supposed to be. Because for one thing, and this always throws me off, there's no claiming territory in dungeons, which really fucks with my head. Like, you could just, build shit wherever you want to if it's underground. Like, you could just put anything anywhere as long as it's underground, and it really fucking messes me up. And the other thing is that, weirdly, the first of them, Dungeons 2 and 3 are very explicitly riffs on the Dungeon Keeper formula, but, like...
Rally upon these specters, and your minions will immediately sally forth to wreak bloody havoc.
It's, like, very explicitly, a riff on Dungeon Keeper. Dungeons 1 plays more like a theme park management game, which is very strange.
Well done. Now finish off the rest of these manifestations with a second rally flag.
Because in Dungeons 1, you're, like, building distractions to, like, farm stuff from the heroes who enter your dungeon, rather than just trying to protect your dungeon heart. Like, Dungeons started with a more original idea and then turned into a Dungeon Keeper ripoff. It's very odd.
Rally flags by slapping them with a right click. This should allow your minions to return to their jobs. And tend their needs in a timely fashion.
I think I put too much effort
recall upon a minion
into
to immediately return them to your dungeon. Though if they are attacked as it channels, then the spell will fizzle into nothing.
I think I put too much effort into
you're on a roll
into building this, because I'm fairly certain. Yeah, that's where the level ends. I put too much thought into building my dungeon.
Let us enter the realm of Kairos.
Because the first level is literally just teaching you the very basic controls of the game. Okay. I think I started playing this. I got like 3 levels in and then stopped.
It's all coming back quite quickly.
So I can do it on the stream.
I expected nothing less. But there's much still to learn. Why don't we work in a bit of murder while we're at it? It's time for you to enter the realm of Kairos.
Okay. Oh wait, single player campaigns. I don't know why it kicked us out of there, but here we go.
Now's the time for a bigger challenge. Before you lies an imperial keep, guarded by a certain Lord Rusimov. He had a bit of an accident that melted most of his face. but he's no less vigilant a soldier. He's been sent to guard an object that could threaten our campaign. Get in there and burn the rest of him, Underlord.
I think an open plan look might be nice. You know, I've seen people who play Dungeon Keeper by making, like, open plan dungeons, and I hate it. Like, I can't say whether or not it's good or bad. I just hate it.
Crafted defenses to keep us from the heart of their kingdom. These inhibitors prevent underlords from trespass, but whether it's bone or stone, it can be broken. I suspect that this Empire force has yet to taste true battle. But before you go engaging them, you'll need to muster up some minions. Unfortunately for me, your time in the ether has left you a weak husk of your former self. In order to reacquire your powers, you will need to access the veins of evil. Open them now, and use a sin to unlock the archive.
Oh yeah, this is one of the things that differentiates it from Dungeon Keeper.
Which can be spent to recover
your lost powers.
You've
got a tech tree.
Build one now to begin researching
additional things. Yeah, I'll get around to it. Back off. Back off, demon dad. Chillax. I'll get there eventually. God. Again, I believe he is actually an evil god. I think that is what he is, but well, it's fine.
To have your workers prioritize objectives in a specific area, place a worker rally banner in that location. Build an archive, Underlord.
Yeah, I'm fucking...
Your forgotten powers are far more impressive than those you currently wield.
I'm getting there! Chill out! Jesus! Okay. Okay, that's impenetrable. Well, we found where the lair's going, I guess. We'll put the pig place here, and we'll put the lair here, because the lair... doesn't need, like, interactables in it to work, so... Actually, then again, neither does the slaughter pen, really. It doesn't actually... It doesn't, like, spawn actual, like, objects in it, but it... Or does it? I can't actually remember. I'm genuinely not sure anymore. Ah, well. We have a perception shrine, anyway. All's good. Should also probably at some point actually get ourselves a vault. I'm a dark hallways and torches kind of person. Yeah. You know, you want a dark... You know, you want your secret underground evil base. Oh, yeah, it does have interactables. Well, not interactables, but, like, actual, like, setting items in it. Put the lair.
Build a larger vault under
there. Then we put the archives here. Or at least we will when they've finished claiming all the tiles. You see, this is how you lay out a dungeon. This is how you lay out a dungeon. A series of squares. It's just a series of handsome, well-maintained squares. And occasionally, whatever the fuck's going on over there. Occasionally just, piles of, ill-laid-out, rooms, because you just need some, plop beds down. But mostly, well-maintained, well-manicured squares. I don't know if anything I just said actually made sense.
You need to find a nearby gateway before minions can enter your dungeon.
Mm-hmm. and we'll just do what... Again, I don't know why this is a thing that I do, but I tend to build vaults around the gateways. I don't know why that's a thing I do. It's just a thing I like doing. I prefer the shiny corporate evil. No, shiny corporate evil's boring. You need, like, classic old-school evil, because then at least you know what you're dealing with, you know? Old-school, classic evil?
You have claimed a gateway. A cultist has found its way into your dungeon.
Also, I do enjoy that the cultists attracted appear to just be ghost fans.
Within your archive. These minions will spend most of their
just metalheads with hoodies. Sins for
though they are weak combatants, they have the power to curse your foes, making them weak to your other minions' blows. A cultist has entered your dungeon.
Okay, now we should be able to get gnarlings in here as well.
A gnarling has entered your dungeon.
I was sold the minute they mentioned a micro piglet farm. Yeah, look. Tiny little pigs. Kevin Bacon, fuck. I didn't realize they had names. Daddy Pig, Oinky. I didn't realize the pigs had names, I'm gonna be honest. And yeah, look at the beds of the cultists as well. Like, they're just metalheads. They're just like a very annoying metalheads. It's very annoying metalheads. That's all the cultists are. Okay, that looks like there might be something over there. Can you possess the pigs? Yes! Their one ability is oink. Their vision is shit. Like, their vision is absolutely awful. Why? Why is their vision so bad? What the fuck?
Use it within the veins of evil to unlock the tavern. This room provides your minions with succulent cooked pig flesh and stout ales. After eating a meal within its hearthed halls, their spirits will
and do the gnarlings have names?
Their productivity for a short
yes,
time.
That one is Skulch. Got LARP over there. I think everything has names. Yeah, the cultists, like Peroculus or whatever the fuck. Tyler, Wistoria, Tyler. But I mean, they are just humans, so that actually checks out. They would probably have some weird. The Unspoken. One of them has a cool name.
Unlocked.
There's like one dude there with a cool name.
The tavern is an essential room for keeping your minions fed. As they increase in level, they will eventually rebel if there is no tavern to sate their hunger. Build one now, and remember that the tavern is unique and must be built at least 3x5 in order to be effective.
Okay, this is going to be a bit of a difficult... I think we're going to have to...
I never get hungry in here for some reason. Replacement Earth complete.
We don't really have any good space to build the tavern. Okay, hang on. Hang on.
Sometimes I wonder if I'm not keeping it. Who the hell is Brian?
Hang on. Okay, hang on. I think...
Payday has come again. You'll still need a slaughter pen in order to keep your tavern stocked. But in a pinch, you can always drop some alternative meat into the grinder. Rooms will only attract a certain number of minions before becoming full. In order to attract more, you'll need to expand them. Nothing in this life is free, Underlord.
Okay.
And you'll regularly need to pay your minions for their hard work. Be sure to keep an eye on your reserves, for if you've not enough gold for their wages, they'll be swift to find gainful employment elsewhere. Fortunately, your minions will return some of their earnings by buying meals within your own tavern.
Hang on, we need to think about this. The squares are being jeopardized. The plan is falling apart. Okay, what if we... Can we... Would this work? I think that could work. As the tavern, and then that's the lure.
Scouts, go find what the hell's making all that racket.
Rally your minions to defeat these scouts once they breach your dungeon. Let's keep Sarusimov in the dark a little while longer.
Shut up.
You should try using the lightning and heal spell to assist your minions in combat.
Okay, let's quickly give that order so everyone will go. Did I put the right one down? Yeah, I did.
The health of minions is represented.
There we go.
Petals.
Okay, now the gnarlings are going to get into a fight.
Once no petals remain, a creature will fall unconscious and soon die. Unless returned to
Wait,
its
lair
to recover.
The workers are fighting them. Oh, wait, is it because the Okay, it might be because the dwarves are technically the forces of goods equivalent of workers. So that could be why they're willing to fight them. Even though they're normally not willing to fight them. Normally they are.
If your minions ignore rally flags and remain focused on their current objectives, you can assign them to the peace band.
They should be back by now. Bar the doors. We wait for reinforcements.
Look how easily your minions cut down these sappers. If I didn't know better, I'd say the Empire is broke. Unprepared.
Yeah, the Empire is woefully unprepared for a handful of goblins. And their goth friends. Okay. You know, fuck it. We're not building a big fancy place here. That'll do. In fact, actually, you know what? We'll make one big tavern, actually. We'll connect
these. If any of
your
minions fall in combat, your workers will attempt to rescue them and return them to their lair, where they may rest and recover. Dismiss your rally flag to let your minions mend their wounds and return to work. Slap the rally flag to dismiss it and allow your minions to tend their needs. Once minions are rested, you can leave them to their work or force them to train by dropping them in a barracks.
Okay, there we go. That's how our tavern's working. And we'll just, you know, seal up the perception tribe. Gotta go past the big spooky eye, ain't ya? You gotta go past the big scary fucking Sauron eye over here. We'll also say this as another point of comparison to dungeons. like between dungeons and this game is this game has it feels a lot more like Dungeon Keeper in terms of its like its tone, I guess. Because dungeons is very.
You don't want to do something, you could at least vocalize it, Underlord.
Dungeons is very kind of lighthearted and silly. Compared to this. Whereas, yeah, like, this and Dungeon Keeper are both, like, comedic games. But the humor in them is very specifically, like, dark comedy, and there's, like, kind of a grim edge to the aesthetic, you know? Like, it doesn't lean super hard. It's not, like, absurd. Dungeons is absurd. Like, in terms of how it depicts it. It's almost like the difference... I was gonna say, like, it's the difference between, say, like, Fable and Overlord, but Overlord and Fable almost feel like they could take place in the same fucking world, just different parts of it. But yeah, like, Dungeons is a lot more Overlord, than, Dungeon Keeper. You know? To the point at which, like, the voice, like, the narrator...
is unhappy because it is tired.
The narrator for Dungeons is, is the Stanley Parable guy. Like, literally, it's just the Stanley Parable guy.
Let's get cracking.
I think there's supposed to be an artifact lying around here somewhere. It might literally be here. Hang on. I think it's up here. Hang on. Let's go for an explore. Yeah, this is a suspicious. Yeah, that's. Yep, there it is. Okay. I was gonna say this is a suspiciously long tunnel. Oh, you can control the doctor. Yeah, you got a possession spell. It's not normally ideal, but it is something you can do. Yeah, you find those artifacts, you drag them back to your archive, and your cultists will figure out what's going on with them.
The enemy have breached the damn walls. Steal yourselves, lads.
Why won't you please?
That's enough training for now. When you're ready, rally your minions to the inhibitor and defeat Sarusimov.
Yeah, fuck it. Let's just give the order. Everyone! Everyone, it's war. Why does the narrator sound like someone out of 40k? Because that's just what he sounds like. And he's literally the narrator of the original Dungeon Keeper games. That they just got back for the spiritual successor. It's just because he's got a cool voice. Although, I don't know if he's ever voiced anything 40k related. I did mention earlier in the stream that he actually voices a character in Total War Warhammer. He voices the Dwarf King Thorgrim Grudgebearer in Total War Warhammer. Yeah, there is one thing that I do find interesting is that the forces of good do kind of have, like, equivalents to most of the dungeons, or most of the dungeon, like, minions. Which I guess actually makes sense, because effectively... While, if memory serves, the enemy AI in most of the campaign doesn't really build dungeons, although you do eventually end up fighting other underlords. Hang on. Oh, wait, shit. Is that... Oh, can only be used in my own territory. Well, fuck. Well, I can heal people on my own terms, I guess. He doesn't look like his face is burnt.
Out of his misery. Well done, Underlord. You're learning much faster this time. We've barely even started, and you already have a notch on your belt. Well done, Underlord. But there's no rest for the wicked. Two inhibitors still stand between us and the mainland. But after your butchery of poor Lord Rusimov, I doubt they'll be weakly defended.
That's what the artifact was. It would have just given us a bunch of gold. Not that we really needed it. Why does it... Okay, there we go. It keeps trying to put us
progress,
on the...
Underlord.
Very strange.
You'll be back to your old self in no time. Our next target is the citadel of the intransigent dotard, Lord O'Thieland. He's a dim-witted sort. And he seems to like marching his troops into an early grave. I'd say it's time to learn about traps.
The narrator is spectacular. Yeah, that's why I'm trying to not speak over him. Is I just want to let him. The behemoth would part of the evolved from a now extinct Red Reaper. That's a reference to the Horned
Welcome
Reaper from the Dungeon Keeper games.
Because
that was the monster
was
on the cover.
This chasm to safekeep one
I should
of
play
the
Dungeon Keeper.
Inhibitors.
Again, it's been ages. Weirdly, I've never actually completed the original Dungeon Keeper. I think I've beaten Dungeon Keeper 2.
Their commander, Lord O'Thieland, is a vacuous sort who will throw his troops at your dungeon without strategy or order. I can think of no better time for you to learn how to build defenses for your dungeon. But to do this, you first need a foundry. Open the veins of evil.
Yeah.
Lock it now. Build one now, and your minions will be happy to create defenses for your dungeon.
Wait, we discovered a gateway. Where the fuck did I discover a gate? Oh, is there a gate? Oh, there's a gateway there. Okay, I was wondering why this area was so deeply fucking weirdly laid out. Okay. We can't get our perfect, like, for...
To plan your dungeon,
our perfect,
why not use
like...
the prophecy spell to clear the fog of war and scout the surrounding terrain.
Shut up. We can't get those perfect, like, squares. But, well, you know what? If you can't get... When you can't get squares, get rectangles. That's what my mother used to say. So, I always thought it was a very fucking strange piece of advice, but... when life gives you lemons... Rectangles. Strange woman, my mother. Very strange woman.
Replacement earth complete.
And yes, I know I'm literally wasting gold with the replacement earth, but I need nice walls around my rooms, man. I can't handle them not being
you
like nice rooms.
Gold tribe.
Can't do it. Try not to injure yourself, Nerdlinger. Come on now. Okay.
You've claimed
yep,
the gold shrine.
Okay. Life gives you lemons, get revenge. Okay. Okay, that I can make into a foundry.
You cannot store more gold.
Oh, wait, yeah, shit. Can I? Okay, I can summon more workers.
You've discovered a perception shrine.
Let's get some more workers so we can actually do this at something like a reasonable pace. Okay, there we go. These... Hang on. Okay. That could be a reasonable... Hang on. That could be a reasonable room. Oh, sweet Jesus, no.
You need an archive and cultists in order to research that artifact.
Okay.
Build a larger vault, Underlord.
Archive. Foundry.
A Chunder has entered your dungeon. Attracted by the foundry, this gassy creature will joyfully launch the fetid contents of its stomach to attack. Your other minions would do well to stay a few steps back.
It's horrific to look at, but, you know, he's trying his best.
Your minions' needs are not being met, Underlord. Build them the basic rooms they require.
You know, just trying not to think about the fact that its name literally means vomit. Just trying not to think about it.
You've claimed the perception shrine. A cultist has entered your dungeon.
And the fact that they occasionally make farting noises.
Your minions are unfortunate beings of weak flesh. Build them a lair so they may rest.
These are all just things that we shouldn't think about.
Replacement
oh, wait, yeah, no, shit, we need a lair. I mean, the lair, again, we are fortunate in that the lair doesn't have to actually look like anything, so we can just, like...
has entered your dungeon.
We can just, like, make the lair look like a fucking piece,
is an
randomly laid out piece of shit. Fed.
As they increase in level, they will eventually rebel if there is no tavern.
Yeah, I know. I'm dealing with it. Chill out. God. Getting on my nerves.
Look at it. It thinks it's deep.
What do the Chunders live on? Oh yeah, a toilet. That's the Chunder's bed. It's genuinely a toilet. The Chunders are the worst. Just want that on record, that the Chunders are the worst. They are quite possibly the worst thing in the game. Just dreadful. Just dreadful. Absolutely unacceptably foul as creatures, and I do not like them. They remind me too much of some of the people I've worked with. Okay.
Blade Lotus unlocked.
We also need to get a training room. There's, like, several things we need that we don't have. It said we learned... Oh, yeah, there it is. Like, I was going to say, I'm pretty sure it said we got a gold shrine somewhere, but I couldn't remember. I don't know where the gold shrine is. Gold shrine, it just produces infinite gold. That's all that's going on there. You know, we'll actually build more lair around there. So you just got a big lair over here. Because then we can build the, it just makes sense to build the vault around, around the thing that spawns infinite gold.
You have insufficient funds to do that. Not enough gold.
Can this be a good training room? Seal that up, maybe? I mean, there's impassable rock, which means we're not getting a nice square, but again...
You identified an artifact of joy. Replacement Earth complete. Your units have been made happy.
God, I swear to God, it's the farting, man. I hate
Open
it.
Open the veins of evil. And unlock the Blade Lotus.
I've already unlocked the Blade Lotus, you piece of shit.
Flower of destruction that tears nearby enemies into shredded flesh as it pushes them away. To build defenses for you need simply to lay their blueprints upon a claimed tile.
So this is one of the I did the first three levels.
will work to craft defense parts within your foundry, which will then be ferried off by your workers to construct. Select the Blade Lotus and build it upon the flashing tile.
Hang on.
It is payday. Replacement Earth complete.
I'll fill you with poison.
A gnarling has entered your dungeon.
Okay.
You're out of gold.
We don't have the money for that. Whoops.
If you could build the defense before the heat.
Shut the fuck up!
Universe, I would be grateful.
I like taking my time. Fuck off. Mr. Narrator, if that is your real name, which it definitely isn't, because I can't remember what your name is, but I'm pretty sure you're. What the fuck? What the fuck?
Replacement Earth complete.
Don't quite know what happened there, but that's interesting. Okay, he... And yeah, you know what? Fuck it. Let's just get more vault space as well. Fuck it. Why not?
Replacement Earth complete.
Okay. This is also another one of the reasons why I
splendidly done, Underlord.
Never got around to really doing this, is that I take a lot of time in these because I just like building bases.
These defenses require a small portion of your mana in order to function. You will regain this locked mana when the defense is destroyed or sold. Many of the defenses you build can be toggled between two distinct modes, each with their own effects. Toggle the Blade Lotus by clicking it now.
I'll get around to that. I'm just gonna real quick.
The Blade Lotus can be dropped into a hidden mode, which allows enemies to unknowingly pass over it. The perfect trap for retreating foes. Now click the Blade Lotus again to reactivate it.
Yep.
The Blade Lotus will carve your enemies down to size, unless you're fighting those stinking dwarves, who will end up pint-sized. Due to its small size, the Blade Lotus is most effective in tight corridors. For a bit more firepower and range, you should consider the Bombard. This defense will launch flaming iron balls at any foe that mistakenly wanders too close, swiftly turning their bodies into broken vessels of blooded mash. Select the Bombard and build it upon one of the flashing tiles to the east of your dungeon core. The Bombard can be placed into overdrive mode by clicking it, which will increase the speed at which it Now that you have some offense, you should wall off your dungeon core to prevent your enemies from sneaking in and destroying it. Build a wooden door upon the flashing tile. The wooden door will slow the advance of your enemy for a short time. However, it can also be used to prevent your minions from wandering into haunted corridors or private baths. The wooden door can be toggled open and closed with a click. While closed, no minions may pass through unless the door is opened, destroyed, or sold. You've caught on quick, Underlord. Now put your murderous new talents to work. There's no doubt that the insipid Lord will soon learn of your presence and send his troops forth to die by your hand. In the meantime, you should continue to build defenses to protect your dungeon, adding any additional rooms you desire to diversify your army and improve your chances of survival. Should you wish to speed up the construction of your defenses, you can pick up defense parts from your foundry and drop them directly onto blueprints.
That is genuinely something I did not know I could do.
Wooden door complete.
I've actually played through this campaign multiple times and I did not know this was an option I had. Okay, interesting. Okay.
Blade Lotus complete.
We have the other path up here.
Bombard complete.
Leave that as it is. Just try to seal these up so we can build defenses around here.
Replacement Earth complete. You've discovered a gold shrine.
I think the game's only now decided to tell us about this gold shrine we've been using for a while.
Wealth for your dungeon. If your coffers are full, or if you're afraid of how wealth might change you, you can always untack it with a second click.
Huh.
This evil presence shall not stand up to my might. Rally straight forth to assault them, men!
How terribly kind of the nitwit to announce his attack. Prepare to defend the center line, Underlord. You're out of gold, Underlord. Wooden door complete.
Okay.
The enemy has broken through your walls. Your blade lotus is under attack. Bombard complete.
The traps are pretty good.
What do you mean they're all dead? This threat is more serious than I thought.
Yeah, the trap.
In a minute, I shall prepare a new plan of attack to thwart this devil.
The traps are doing good work. I'm hoping
your minions, Underlord.
I'm hoping we'll be able to get the
have engaged the enemy.
The achievement for destroying their defenses. Destroying them before the last wave of attacks happens. I'm like, what's up? Nothing much. Just playing some I can't believe it's not Dungeon Keeper.
You're a scepter. They've all been bested? Okay, hold on. I'm thinking.
Okay, fortunately, we took long enough at doing everything else that we've managed to build an army that can actually just take out this stuff pretty easily already. Okay.
Swiftly. It lies open and undefended, but for that odious blackguard. You have discovered a gateway. Your minions are fighting the enemy.
We discovered a gateway. Where the fuck did we discover a gateway?
Not enough mana.
I mean, okay, we apparently discovered a gateway. I'm not entirely sure where we discovered a gateway, but we apparently discovered a gateway somewhere. Okay, the inhibitor's gone.
Gnarling lost.
Unfortunately, a gnarling died, which is always a terrible tragedy. It's cast the prophecy spell completely unnecessarily. Oh god, we've lost... Oh god, we've lost Achunda. Whatever will we do now that Achunda has died? The Dear Sweet Chundas were always my favourite. And definitely not creatures that I find deeply fucking unpleasant. Because every noise they make sounds like a wet fart.
Have none of you had any training at all?
Silence has never sounded quite so...
Okay.
Superbly executed. Before we move on, I must warn you, the next inhibitor comes with an unpleasant surprise.
And yep, got an achievement for killing, for finishing that level before they got, before
fine
the
work,
last thing, yep.
Now that Otheland and his cronies are a dehydrated paste, let's move on with our assault and destroy the final inhibitor.
Okay.
Revenge is a dish best served cold, Underlord. But we're a bit lacking in refrigeration. The traitorous coward Marcus has made a deal with the Empire to save his own revolting hide. He defends the final inhibitor. And in exchange, the Empire's dogs leave him to cower behind his dungeon's walls. Get in there, Underlord, and tear it all down.
Horrifying. The idea of a... I still don't really understand what the Underlords are. Again, I think they're basically demons. I don't fully understand what they're supposed to be, but they seem to be something vaguely demon-like.
Here entrenched lies the traitorous Underlord Marcus.
With his much cooler-looking dungeon heart.
He has pledged to protect this inhibitor with his life, having convinced the Empire that he means them no harm. The pathetic little turd.
I think there used to be a way to get his dungeon tile, sir.
This uneasy peace has lasted too long. Vanquish this traitorous underlord and destroy the inhibitor he protects.
It might have been a Kickstarter backer reward.
This place is riddled with brimstone. Its hardened exterior will be impossible to mine using conventional means. But we have other forms of excavation.
I'm intensely unhappy because I've just realized that this is going to be hideous. This our base
open
is going to be
the
hideous.
Veins of evil,
yep, the Underminer.
The Underminer. The Underminer excels at blasting through large chunks of earth. See for yourself by building one near your dungeon core. Unlike defenses, constructs can be placed on neutral territory and in water. Once you have laid the blueprint down, your workers will channel your unholy energies to construct them. Ah, I should have mentioned. Brimstone is a fairly volatile substance. Now that you're out, look east to see an abandoned beast den. You can use the wooden bridge to span your dungeon across water. Build one to the island in order to claim the beast den. This room will allow bloodthirsty beasts to enter your dungeon. Unlike normal minions, beasts cannot work nor train themselves in your barracks. They wish only to strip the flesh from your enemies. In addition, they do not require payment or a lair. And they are more than happy to eat micro piglets straight from your slaughter pen. However, these unfortunate creatures care not for their own lives and will fight until their last breath. They cannot be saved if they fall in battle. The Skarg is a deceptively cute beast that prefers the flesh of dwarves above all and can be trained to fetch and return eyeballs.
Just eyeballs? Like, very specifically trained to fetch and return just eyeballs. Interesting species. Okay, let's quickly get one of them. Okay.
An Oculus has entered your dungeon.
Ah, shit, it's an Oculus Rift.
The Oculus is a master of the mind. If it encounters an enemy, it will assault their senses, temporarily turning them into a vegetable. Outside of battle, the Oculus will explore the depths of the underworld, relaying back what it sees to you and to its eldritch hive mind. You can rally all of your beasts to battle using the Beast Rally Flag.
Ah, yes, use the Oculus, also known as the copyright free, the copyright acceptable variant of a beholder. Just the how to add a beholder to your game without getting sued. Call it an Oculus.
You've claimed the Perception Shrine. You've discovered a Perception Shrine. Your vault is empty.
Ah, shit, our vault's empty.
You've encountered an Empire patrol. No sense in letting them get away now, is there?
Hang on, shit. Ah, yeah, that is one of the problems with the Oculus. I can't remember what exactly the monster
your
is, but there was a...
are in combat.
But there was a monster in, the original Dungeon Keeper that basically had the exact same issue as the,
To quickly add plots
as the Oculus.
To your dungeon, you can use an outpost, which will claim tiles in a 3x3 radius once constructed.
Had the exact same issue as the Oculus, and they would, like, go out and explore. I think it might have been, like, a dragonfly or something like that, like a big insect, like, in Dungeon Keeper 2. Used to fly around and explore and get into also, like, just trouble. Just wander around and get in trouble, because it would just, like, because it would just wander around. Like, it would just fuck off
your
sometimes.
Your minions are under attack.
Because it would just fuck off sometimes. Ah, there we go. Okay.
You've claimed a gold shrine.
And yeah, everything has to be open. I hate levels like this, by the way. Just saying. I, like, absolutely despise levels that are laid out like this. Like, I have a... There's, like, a few. There's, like, a My Pet Dungeon, I think, that's laid out like this as well. It's... Oh, my God. Like, I hate them so much. Given that I like tunnels and rooms, I think you can... I don't think I need to explain why I don't like how this is laid out. I think we can all just understand why I hate how this is laid out.
Claimed a gateway.
Okay, how are we doing for creatures? We should also actually build it. Hasn't it just occurred to me? We don't actually have a slaughter pen. Whoops.
You've claimed the Perception Shrine. Your minions are fighting the enemy. have claimed a gateway. Skarg lost.
That's definitely just the wrong thing I just built there. There we go. Okay, and now we can put... slaughter pen there. Build more treasury. I'm just gonna make this central island just a big treasury. Fuck it. Wonder if we'll ever get a dungeon keeper style game for the Skaven. Yeah, that wouldn't be a bad shout. I'd play that. Like, dungeon keeper, like, where, yeah, like, it's literally, like, you're just running, like, Skaven Blight. Yeah, that'd be fun. That would work. Like, that would very much work. Like, thematically, that's very on brand. Because this is more or less how Skaven work. Like, almost exactly. Except just for, you know, because of the realities of it being a tabletop war game, the Skaven do have suspiciously frequently bugger off up to the surface to do, like, normal war. But, like, other than that, yeah, this is more or less how the Skaven function. Where they would just be building, like, little cities underneath things. Okay, we need more gold.
Let's hope your vault is brimming, Underlord. It is payday.
Yeah, it's payday, but I've got nothing but monsters in my... like, nothing but beasts in my employ right now. Like, I don't have to worry about shit. Hang on. Hey. Although, actually, I think... yeah, there we go. Then this becomes Chunder Island. Gods, but I don't like Chunders.
Has entered your dungeon.
Your minions are being attacked.
Where are my minions being attacked exactly? Oh, up there. I see. Okay. I see.
Your minions have entered battle. Oculus lost.
Again, fights the goblins of the dwarves, expanding into under empire shit and building cities under other settlements. Maybe choose what clan to focus on primarily. Yeah, like, there is that. There is, like, a good idea there. Like, that could very much work. I'd buy it, you know? I'd buy a game that was, that was that. Like, that sounds like that could be a lot of fun.
Your minions fight the enemy.
I suppose it makes sense that the Skargs don't really... guess it makes sense the Skargs don't really do training, because they are monsters. They're not exactly sentient. You know what, we can just fill this, like, the rest of the space here with, like, more lair. The lair doesn't need to be, like, a continuous, unbroken thing, really. And fill this with more treasury.
You've not got two coins to rub together, Underlord. Mine more gold.
Summon the beasts.
Hmm.
gotta go kill the giant. What is he? Is he a... I don't even know what this guy is. Unfucking friendly. Unfucking friendly is what that guy is. All of our sweet little beasties here are just trying to be good lads, and then that motherfucker has to come and ruin it for everyone. By being unfucking friendly.
Your minions are in combat.
That's presumably just the Oculus attacking a door again, isn't it? Yeah. God damn, but the Oculus like attacking doors.
Cultist has entered your dungeon.
Okay.
Your minions fight the enemy.
I think that's it in terms of what rooms we need, actually.
It power naps. I am here.
We'll get more pigs, but
your minions fight the enemy.
Here for some reason.
Oculus lost.
Your vault is empty.
Yeah, let's try to take this over. I don't know what this is, but let's try to take it over. I'm not even sure how one would go about building defenses for this level.
Oculus lost.
Just purely off the back of the fact that, like... Hang on. There we go. Just purely off the back of the fact that we can't really make choke points, because everything's just water. Vampire game got cancelled tomorrow. That sucks. That does suck. If it makes you feel any better, both of my tabletop games every week are basically cancelled for the foreseeable future, because one of the players is... Because the guy who runs the D&D game and is, like, one of the four players in the Pathfinder game is just gone because of family stuff for, like... We don't know how long he's gonna be gone. Like, we have no idea. Like, he has no clue how long it's gonna take.
Skarg lost.
See, shrines improve the speed at which your workers dig through earth and fortify walls.
You've discovered a perception shrine.
Yeah, it's built an underminer. Yeah, so my Pathfinder game's like gone for the foreseeable. Tragically. I'll survive, but it makes me sad. Did I build that other training area? I don't think I did I? No, let's build another training area.
Underminer complete.
And let's blow that up. There we go, we've got... two of these guys that are just in the peace band.
Payday has come again.
We've got like a bunch of artifacts that we just fundamentally don't know what they are still, which isn't great. Just a bunch of shit that we don't know what they are. The vampire game hasn't been passed right up after multiple months. Fun thing is that I'm supposed to be writing a vampire game. I'm supposed to be writing the second half of my Skellwitch campaign. But I'm, like, increasingly... Also, I've just realized something that I should do. Hang on, give me a moment. If I'm doing this, I should be over here. Because I just realized I've been covering the objectives the whole time. One thing that I should be doing... One thing that I'm supposed to be doing is I've kind of low-key decided that I want to run a Pathfinder game instead. So I've kind of just put that on the back burner while I'm just enjoying playing games for a while. And then when I've got more Pathfinder books, I'm going to start reading the Bloodlords campaign, which is a lawful evil Pathfinder campaign, because I want to try that.
A cultist is unhappy because,
Pathfinder 2nd Edition, shockingly, is a fantasy RPG I actually enjoy, as opposed to what, like, D&D 5e is, which is a fantasy RPG that I tolerate. I actually actively enjoy playing Pathfinder, which is fascinating. Okay, now everyone can go satisfy their disgusting urges. Oh, wait, hang on. Actually, yeah, you know, I'll keep the beasts rallied. I'll keep the beasts rallied and attacking the traps.
You've identified an artifact of experience. Your units have been blessed with experience.
There we go. I realized that a Skaven Dungeon Keeper game would mean making a model and mechanics for the Broodmother, which is a troublesome thought. Yeah, that would be... that... yeah, that wouldn't be great.
You've identified Speed up your dungeon's expansion by building an outpost.
Yeah, that wouldn't be great. But
you've been blessed with permanent spirit workers.
Might not necessarily have to have a model for a broodmother. Because it could just be that, you know what, you could literally just have it be the gateway system in this, where, like, yeah, there's a broodmother somewhere, but you don't think about that. Like, you're just getting Skaven through a gateway, it's fine.
A gnarling is unhappy because it hasn't been paid.
Just because no one wants to have to think about the broodmothers.
One of your minions is unhappy.
Even though the Skaven don't like thinking about the broodmothers, if they can help it. Just pretend they don't exist. Yeah, exactly. Just do what if everyone else doesn't pretend the broodmothers don't exist, and you'll be a lot happier.
Unleash your hounds to tear the flesh from these Empire goons.
Yeah, at no point did that result in another... Oh, there we go. That's resulted in another pig pen. Yep.
You've identified an artifact of construction.
Is it an... Absolutely and completely unnecessary peculiar wrinkle.
Your
that.
Creatures are in combat.
Oh, there's another. Oh, there's another. Oh. Oh, shit. There's another. Hang on. Genuinely hadn't realized that there was that the other siege thing was over there. Okay, to battle everyone, I guess. You know what? Let's see. Let's see how some of these other creatures say. Oculus. Oh, that's unpleasant.
Stone Underlord. Why not?
Chunder. It sees everything but kind of gassy.
Your minions
gnarling. Oh, yeah, we already did the gnarling. Cult. That's a chunder again. How do the cultists see the world? Through a hood, I imagine. Yep. And finally, what about the Skarg? Oh god, like a horrible bug. Yeah, I'm gonna just stop emptying these islands out. I'm just gonna steal all this shit.
Lost.
means of fighting the enemy.
I'm just trying to destroy the traps here. I just want to blow the traps up. Is that so wrong? Then yeah, just wreck this last trap and door and that. Should be this leg of the invasion completed. And I think they're just gonna, yeah, they were just gonna destroy the door because they were just all right next to it. Why wouldn't they? Why wouldn't they? That's the question. Ooh, there's a perception shrine and a gateway over there. That's good.
Minion is unhappy because it hasn't slept.
Oh, well, it can just... Well, they can go to bed now. The fight's done. The war is over. Well, the war's not over, but the fight's done. I don't even really need the siege things. Like, I'm not massively concerned with them, honestly. It's just because there's an achievement for it.
It's
like
time to pay your minions, Underlord.
It's one of the optional things that I can do for this, so I feel like I should do it. Okay, that's impassable, I'm pretty sure. Where actually is the... Okay, there we go. Okay, so that's where the actual target's base begins. Okay. Perhaps need more lair space? I'm gonna put down more lair space. You know, I'll make this into another beast zone. I don't even think the beasts even need beds. They seem to just kind of wander around. They seem like fine. They don't seem to care about having a place to actually sleep. They don't need a place to rest their weary heads. They don't have weary heads. They have angry souls and furious hearts. That sounds too much like something that would be a serious comment. Yeah, I don't know on what, but it sounds like I think that meant something. Right? Does anyone else get that? But that kind of sounds like I think that meant something.
The Empire presence is fish food. Well done, Underlord.
And now let's also just get everyone else here one by one.
Underminer complete.
Blow up that using the Underminer.
You have claimed a gateway.
Yeah. Excellent. The war begins. Because, for real, how fucking dare he work for the enemy? Who does he think he is? Working for the other side?
Withdraw your minions immediately.
Nope. It's a bit late for that, bud. I've already started, like, eating your base. If you're gonna try and menace me with, like, a spooky voice, you probably should have done that before I, literally broke your doors down. Late is the hour that this guy's coming up here with a spooky voice.
Oculus lost.
Someone's car alarm's going off outside. So I can just hear the incessant beeping.
You've identified an artifact of joy. Your units have been made happy.
Let me set it again. I do like his minion. The skin on his minions, though.
Your constructs are being summoned. You've discovered a perception shrine.
That's gonna go up in flames. Good. Does he even have monsters? It kind of seems like he doesn't even have minions. Like, maybe he had a couple once, but they all seem to be gone now. Yeah, it seems that all he's got left is workers. Poor bugger.
You've discovered a gold shrine.
Oh no, he has a chunder.
Oculus lost.
There is a chunder in there. Okay, no, he did have minions. He was just hiding them. Okay.
Withdraw your minions immediately. Lost.
Insufficient. Oculus lost.
I can taste death. Fast approaching. The ether beckons. Can you feel it tugging as I do?
And there he goes.
An enemy's dungeon core.
You'll regret not heeding my advice. Underlord, this campaign will be the end of you.
Pay no attention to his frightened blabbering. Now that his core is a smoldering ruin, there are other matters that need your attention. The Underlord Raskos was locked in a scrap with a gaggling of greasy midgets, but has since gone silent. Get over there and find out what the hell is going on.
And yep, we just got another achievement. I assume, for getting all of the...
job well done, Underlord.
Yeah, for getting all the shrines.
Marcus's shattered spirit will not soon forget the price of his cowardice. Now that the inhibitors all lay broken, only one final snag prevents us burning the heart of their land.
Right, well, that... is probably going to be it from me for today. I will be back on Sunday with another stream. And then hopefully, I think next week, it should be normal streams most of the week. I think I'm doing overtime next Sunday. Like, not this Sunday coming, but the Sunday after and the Sunday after that. So, I won't be doing... I'll be back this Sunday. And I'll let everyone know. But yeah, so that's gonna be it for me for now. Hope you enjoyed the stream. I'll see you guys next time. Bye!
The emancipation of the working class is the task of the worker alone. So left to three, so left to three, to the work that we must do. March on in the workers' united front, for you are a worker too.